Praise the Lord.
Amen.
How are you this morning?
Fine, in the Lord.
It's a wonderful day the Lord has made. Amen.
Amen.
Because the Lord has given us this day to rejoice in it. Amen.
Amen.
So it is good to rejoice in the name of the Lord who has given us this day.
Amen.
In spite of everything, God is on the throne.
Amen.
And God is a God who works good things.
Amen.
He is saying, in spite of that, he is thinking good things about us.
Amen.
God has never thought about us evil things.
Amen.
He says, for these are the thoughts I have towards you. These are the plans I have for you.
Amen.
To give us a future and an expected end. Amen?
Amen.
So it is good to have hope. It's good to wait on God.
Amen.
Wait on God, somebody. For he is coming, he's not tarrying. Amen?
Amen.
Today, I would like us to bring you to a message. Receive God's grace. Receive God's grace. Amen?
Amen.
And the word grace here comes from the Hebrew word Chesed. Chesed means goodness, faithfulness, kindness. So when you hear me mention God's mercy, I'm mentioning his goodness, his faithfulness, and his kindness. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But also, if you go to the Bible, the word mercy is also written as Racham in Hebrew, which also means compassion. So you can add God's goodness, faithfulness, kindness, and compassion. Glory to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God is holy, somebody. God is righteous. And wherever he appears, becomes holy. He told Moses when he appears on the mountain that no one should touch or come near the mountain because it's holy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But it's his mercy that keeps us. It is mercy that preserves us. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
For if God was to come to us without mercy, who would stand? As David says in Psalm 1:3, he said that if God were to mark our iniquities, if God were to mark our iniquities, O Lord, who would stand before you? That was David. He looked at himself and said, God, I cannot stand before your presence. It is honoring your mercy. Amen?
Amen.
As Romans 3:23 says, that all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. We are born of Adam, we are born sinners. But it's the grace of God and through his mercies, hallelujah,
Amen.
That God keeps every human being. Even those who have not known Jesus. There are people walking in wickedness and evil, but they are preserved by God's mercy. Amen.
Amen.
Because God is so merciful. He visits us at the place of his mercy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He visits, he comes to us and comes to visit us at the place of the mercy seat. That's why after deliverance from Egypt, Moses, after leading the children of Israel through the Red Sea, in the wilderness, God said, now I want to dwell in the midst of you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He told the children of Israel in Exodus 25:8 that I want to live with you. And so make me a sanctuary that I may come and dwell with you. Glory to God.
Amen.
And he told Moses, therefore Moses, in Exodus 25:17, make me a mercy seat which should be covered with gold, overlaid with gold, made with gold. You know, it has to represent heaven because heaven, the streets are of gold. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And God told Moses in Exodus 25:32, and God said to Moses, there I will meet with you and I will speak with you from above the mercy seats. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God will come to the tents. He will come to the tabernacle. He will come to the sanctuary and he will meet with Moses at the mercy seat, glory to God.
Amen.
This is a position at which God meets with us. This is a position at which God meets with his people. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is why afterwards, when he came up with the Levitical priesthood, glory to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The high priest would go to the most holy place every year and would appear before the mercy seat with the blood, hallelujah,
Amen.
To obtain mercy for the people,
Amen.
To obtain mercy for the Israelites. I give God the glory today. We have a high priest, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus Christ is the expression of God's mercy towards us. He carries the fullness of God's mercy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He is the high priest through whom we have obtained mercy, even the forgiveness of our sins. Glory to God.
Amen.
And it says in Hebrews 9:24, for Christ has not entered into the holy place made with hands, which are true figures, which are the figures of the true. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But he has entered into the heaven itself, now to appear in the presence of God the Father for us. That's our high priest, somebody. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Christ is the high priest. Amen.
Amen.
And he has entered to the holy place in heaven. Not in the earth, not in the tabernacle Moses made, but in the heaven to appear on our behalf. He has gone there once and for all, and he is sitting at the right hand of God. Amen.
Amen.
By Christ's death, that says in Hebrews 5:16, hallelujah, by Christ's death, the way to the holy place has been opened. The curtain was rent into two. Now we can enter to the holy place. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Through Jesus, our high priest, we can enter. We can present ourselves before the master seat. Glory to God.
Amen.
You know, sometimes we may think, oh, what you have done is so big that God cannot forgive us. What you have done is so big that we don't deserve the mercies of God. Or even other times you say, what other people have done, you know that so and so, what they have done, I don't think they deserve God's mercy. What they did to me or what they did to other people, glory to God.
Amen.
But what have you done? What is that you have done you think God cannot forgive you? That you think that the mercies of God cannot apply to you? Listen to me. God did not only forgive Saul. Hallelujah.
Amen.
For persecuting and killing his children, his saints. He did not only forgive him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But he made him an apostle of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Christ on the cross, when he was hanging there, he forgave all those who crucified him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He was in great pain, but still he forgave.
Yes.
That's what I'm talking about. The mercies of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is the God I am looking, that talking about. Glory to God.
Amen.
That's the God who forgives. Hallelujah.
Amen.
A merciful Savior. Amen.
Amen.
His mercies are new every morning.
Amen.
You can depend on God's mercy, somebody.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to say this, listen carefully. I want to say this, my viewer. One, the mercies of God endures forever. I'm talking about the mercies of God. They endure forever. Psalm 136, the whole of that chapter, 26. Hallelujah.
Amen.
26 times is repeated. The mercies of God endures forever. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They were not only in times of Moses. They were not only in times of Peter. They were not only in times of John. The mercies of God endures forever. That tells you how much God is merciful. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then it says in Psalms 103 verse 17 that God, the mercies of the Lord are from everlasting to everlasting upon them that fear him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And his righteousness to children's children. Imagine from everlasting to everlasting. Glory to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You can depend on God's mercy. You can depend on his faithfulness.
Yes.
You can depend on his goodness and kindness. God is compassionate.
Amen.
He knows what you are
Amen.
Made of. He says, he saw them, they are made of frame of dust.
Amen.
And he had mercy on them. Amen.
Amen.
Number two, God's mercy are plenteous.
Amen.
As east is far from the west, so are God's mercy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let me tell you somebody, you cannot exhaust God's mercy. Maybe you are saying, I've gone to God several times. I'm full of weakness and flaws. And you are feeling you are not now supposed to. You are saying, I give up now. I give up on going to God. Let me walk in the world. Let me walk in this thing. Let me be a prayer. No, God's mercy are precious. You cannot exhaust them. The Bible says in Psalm 86, verse 15, hallelujah.
Amen.
The Lord is full of compassion and gracious and long-suffering and precious in mercy and in truth.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
God has a multitude of mercy. You cannot finish his mercy.
Yes.
Let me tell you somebody, you still have a second chance. Do not cry. Do not just say and give up and decide to walk in a bacterial state or say now, let me live the way I live. Amen.
Amen.
You can learn to God. David said in Psalm 5:7, that said, he said, I come into your house in the multitude of your mercy. You can run to God. You don't have to die. You don't have to live oppressed. You don't have to live in that condition.
Yeah,
hallelujah.
Amen.
God loves you no matter what. God loves you whatever you go through. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Come to God, somebody. Come into the abundant mercy of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Number three, God's mercy are long suffering.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God is patient with us. He is slow to anger. And he is quick to mercy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why he has not judged us. He has not judged you. No matter what you have done, it doesn't matter how bad it is, God has not yet judged you. Glory to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Some people have continued in wickedness. They have continued in evil. Some people have done bad things. Sometimes you say, why are the wicked still there and they still prosper? Why are the wicked not judged? Glory to God.
Amen.
Why are the people still sinning and we see them? They are not bad things are happening to them. It is the mercies of God.
Yes.
It is the mercies of God. Amen?
Amen.
But that does not mean that God is slack or slow to judge people or to punish sin.
Yes.
Somebody don't take it that way. God is not slow. No. God is giving you a chance. God is giving people a chance to repent and to change their lives and receive His grace through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
For God does not want any man to perish.
Yes.
The Bible says, God wants all people to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth.
Amen.
That's why He said that hell was not made for man. Hell was made for Satan and his angels, not for you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why He's so merciful. Hallelujah. Amen. Let us therefore not abuse the mercies of God.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let us not continue rebelliousness and disobedience. Let us not continue in sin. Let us turn from sin and come to our Master. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Turn to the Lord Jesus today.
Oh, yes.
Turn from whatever way you have walked from.
Oh, yes.
Come to Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Number four, there's no sin that God's mercy cannot deal with or acquit. No sin.
Mm-hmm.
No mistake.
Yes.
You know, sometimes we make mistakes.
Mm-hmm.
We can make mistakes.
Yes.
And that mistakes can bring us bad reputation. And we want to hide.
Yeah.
We don't want people to know.
Yeah.
And we are saying, wow, what can I do about my mistakes?
Mm-hmm.
I think I'll keep it.
Mm-hmm.
And Satan has oppressed you and tried to lead you in that path of oppression in the mind and in your meditations,
in
your works, in your worries.
Yeah.
And I'm telling you, there's nothing so hard for God.
Oh, yeah.
What is too hard for God?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Psalm 86 that he says, for great is your mercies, are your mercy towards me, and you have delivered me from the lowest hell. David was saying, great are your mercies. God can deliver you from the lowest hell.
Yes.
What is that place you are going through?
Mm.
Compare it with hell. Is it worse than hell? God can deliver you. I have had people say, I cannot take it anymore. I have had people say, I cannot forgive my husband. I cannot forgive my wife. I cannot forgive so and so. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I have had people say, I've reached the end of myself. But I come to tell you, that is not so with God. God is not yet done with you.
Yes.
His mercies are still new.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
He is long-suffering. He is patient. And God is waiting you. Turn to Him and you will find rest. Glory to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Even in your father and your mother, even when your people reject you, God will receive you. He says, even if a mother throws away a baby who is suffering, glory to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. God will receive him. Glory to God.
Amen.
That's the God I'm talking about. You know, disciples of Jesus went to Jesus and asked, for how long? How many times can I forgive my brother? And they thought Jesus will say 7 times. To them, they thought 7 times is sufficient. But Jesus told them, 70 times 7 in a day. Imagine somebody transgressing against you 70 times in a day. And he comes to you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As you ask forgiveness, God is saying, forgive him.
Yes.
What about God? If he can require or tell us to forgive people 70 times in a day, how much more is God willing to forgive you? How much more is God willing to forgive us?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
How much more are the mercies of God, somebody?
Yes.
Matthew 6:7 says, surely blessed are they you forgive, for
yes.
they shall receive mercy.
Oh, yes.
When you forgive, you receive mercy.
Yes.
Be like God. Be somebody who forgives. Do not
Amen.
Carry bitterness. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Number five, God's mercy do not fluctuate. Hallelujah.
Amen.
His mercies are not, hallelujah.
Amen.
They are steadfast. They are not dependent on the mood or times.
Yes.
God is on a man. You know, somebody say, I'm not in the mood. I don't feel like I can talk to you. I don't feel like God does not walk in the moods. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He is steadfast in mercy. You can turn to God. You can run to God anytime and find mercy. His mercies are ever present. Glory to God.
Amen.
Come to the throne of grace, somebody,
yes.
and you will find mercy.
Yes.
Throw away your bitterness. Throw away yourself to the hands of God.
Amen.
You may feel that you cannot forgive yourself for what you did.
Yes.
There are some people who say that under the circumstances, I wish I could have done more. I wish I could have looked at my father or my mother, taken the care, more care upon their lives.
Yes.
They would not have died. Probably they would not have gone through what they went through.
Yes.
And you're saying, I cannot forgive myself for allowing my husband to die or my wife to die the way she died or my brother or whatever happened, you are blaming yourself. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But I'm here to tell you, there's nothing you could have done more. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
You say, oh, you cannot forgive yourself. But I've come to tell you, God is not holding it against you.
Yes.
God is not holding it against you.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God is not mad at you. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. For the blood of Jesus is speaking good things for you.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Amen. And God's outstretched arms of mercy are towards you.
Oh,
yes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God's mercy through Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And you will find rest for your soul.
Yes.
God will give you rest.
Amen.
As he says in Matthew, hallelujah, 11:27-28, Jesus is telling you, come to me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I'll give you rest.
Yes.
There is a rest for your soul. There is a rest for your life. You can run to God who is merciful.
Yes.
God who is ready to forgive you no matter what.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
You cannot work for mercy. You cannot labor for God's mercy.
Yes.
You cannot work for it. Amen.
Amen.
God forgives freely. Jesus paid for it all. God gives his mercies. They are free. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You have no right or excuse to live in condemnation, self-condemnation, in self guilt, in a guilt conscience.
Amen.
God wants to forgive you.
Yes.
God wants to change your life.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You can run into his arms of mercy. And he received you. Like that was the prodigal son. When he came to his mind. And he said, I'll go to the father. The Bible says, when the father saw him from afar, he ran to him. And he embraced him. And kissed him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He did not condemn him. He forgave him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's how the mercies of our father are. Oh, somebody have an advocate in heaven. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We now have a high priest who is touched by infirmities. Touched by our conditions. Glory to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
For there is therefore no condemnation to them that are in Christ Jesus. Romans 8:1. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
You can count on God's mercy.
Yes.
You can count on his faithfulness.
Yes.
You can count on his kindness.
Yes.
You can count on his compassion. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Somebody.
Amen.
God wants to forgive you. God wants to have mercy upon your life.
Yes.
Can you turn to his hand, to his mercy today? Can you turn to his mercy and he'll heal you? Glory to God.
Amen.
What does God's mercy do in our lives? What does it do? Hallelujah. I want to lead you to what masses. I may not exhaust, but I want to tell you a few what the masses of God can do in your life. Amen. Through God's mercy, our sins are forgiven. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God will not only forgive your sins, but he will remember them no more. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As he said in the Hebrews 10:17, he said that this is a covenant I will make with you, with them, that after these days, amen,
amen,
that their sins and iniquities I will remember no more.
Yes.
God will forgive you and forget what that you did it.
Amen.
If you confess your sins to God, and God forgive you, believe you are forgiven, stop condemning yourself anymore.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because it's by his mercy.
Yes.
We should do also the same to those who have transgressed against us.
Yes.
We forgive them and we forget.
Yes.
Isaiah 55:7 says, let the wicked forsake his ways, and the unrighteous his thoughts. Amen.
Amen.
Let him return to the Lord, for he will abundantly pardon. Return to the Lord.
Yes.
Forsake your ways.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Forsake your wicked thoughts. Forsake any unrighteous thoughts. Amen.
Amen.
The second one, through God's mercy, hallelujah,
amen,
we are healed of our sickness and diseases. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus Christ, in Isaiah 53:4, he bore, he carried your sicknesses, your pain. He carried your sorrows and your griefs. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he says in Isaiah 49:13, for the Lord has comforted his people and you have mercy upon the afflicted.
Yes.
Are you afflicted? Turn to God.
Oh,
he will
yes.
have mercy upon you.
Oh,
he will
yes.
deliver you. He will
yes.
change your life. He will
yes.
change your story.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus had compassion. The Bible says he saw the multitude and he saw they are like a people without a shepherd.
Amen.
And he had compassion on them and he healed all their sick folk.
Amen.
He healed them.
Amen.
Their diseases. He is the same yesterday,
oh,
today
yes.
and forever.
Amen.
He will have mercy on you and
amen.
He will heal you.
Yes.
He has not forgotten you.
Oh,
amen.
Amen.
The third one, God's mercy. Through God's mercy, we receive favor. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He will make you through his mercy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He will make all things turn around for you. Even when then you do not deserve it.
Yes.
God will make things to turn around for you.
Oh, yes.
Because of his mercy. Look at Genesis 39:21. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It says that the Lord was with Joseph. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he showed him mercy. The Lord showed Joseph mercy and gave him favor in the sight of the keeper of prison.
Amen.
Imagine Joseph, a Jew, a slave, hallelujah,
amen,
and now a prisoner, being given charge to be in charge of the whole prison. Imagine him being made a the commissioner of the prisons.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Can you imagine that? Why? God's mercy.
Amen.
God's mercy brings favor.
Yes.
Let me tell you something, when you walk with God's mercy,
yeah,
however much you have been rejected by your brothers,
mm-hmm,
Joseph was rejected by his own people. His own brothers sold him out
amen.
To be a slave. But in the very place he was sought to be a slave, he finds the master of God.
Amen.
Stop blaming those who have done bad things to you.
Yes.
Stop living in the past. Wherever you are, you can find God's mercy.
Amen.
And when you find God's mercy, you will find favor. And when you find favor, you shall be acceptable. You shall increase. You shall prosper.
Amen.
Joseph prospered in Egypt to
yes.
the point that he became the prime minister.
Amen.
The second in command after Pharaoh.
Yes. Amen.
This is God's mercy.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The fourth, God's mercy moves him to deal with our enemies and oppressors. Hallelujah.
Amen.
His mercy makes him to deal with our enemies and oppress us. Psalm 106 verse 24. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. It says, God has redeemed us from our enemies, for his mercy endures forever.
Amen.
You know,
Amen.
I was remembering the story of Jehoshaphat in 2 Chronicles 20. When he went before God and he was encountering five to three kingdoms. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Moabites, the Ammonites, and the people from the Mount Seir. They rose against him. When he went to God, God told him, this is my battle. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He told him, now go. And I see Jehoshaphat understanding this principle. And he sets a choir before his army.
Amen.
Can you imagine a choir meeting and the enemy? The enemy is armed with spears and all manner of weapons. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But they went singing, oh, praise the Lord, for his mercies endure forever. Praise the Lord, for his mercies endure forever. And the Bible says God moved on behalf of Jehoshaphat. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he made the enemy to fight against themselves. They destroyed themselves. Jehoshaphat did not need to fight that battle. He understood the mercies of God.
Amen.
When you walk with the mercies of God, no enemy will touch you.
Amen.
God will turn your battles to be his battles.
Amen.
That's what the mercies of God does in our lives.
Amen.
Jehoshaphat got victory over his enemies. For the mercies of God endure forever. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Number five, or the fifth, God provides for us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Through his mercy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are provided for by God. Glory to God.
Amen.
We are provided for by God through mercy. Hallelujah. Not because of what you have done. Imagine people are so weak and God still give them. Imagine people are so weak and still God provides rain for their farms and their shambas. He does not only bring the rain to the righteous or the sun to the righteous, but also he makes the farms of the people to produce.
Yes.
What is that? It is mercy. Mercy. He provides with us. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says in Psalm 136 verse 25, who gives food to all flesh? For his mercy endure forever.
Amen.
The word is mercy endure forever. Look at it in the Bible. I think it is over 50 times. Even more. He is trying to remind us we can look unto his mercy. Dear
Amen.
Viewer, don't forsake God's mercy today.
Amen.
Don't continue in what you are doing.
Amen.
You don't forsake God's mercy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, you can ask King Saul. You can ask King Saul. And it says in 2 Samuel 7:15. Amen.
Amen.
God talking about David. He says, but my mercy shall not depart away from him or from David, as I took from Saul, whom I put away. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Before. God is saying that he chose David and he removed mercy from Saul. What happened to Saul? An unclean spirit would visit Saul. An evil spirit. Saul was oppressed even to the point of his death. He started thinking of killing people. He was out of killing David. But killing David would not have solved his problems. Glory to God.
Amen.
The mercies of God were removed from his house. And he lost kingship. He lost loyalty for his children. Glory to God.
Amen.
Somebody don't forsake God's mercy. They are new today. You can receive God's mercy today.
Yes.
They are new every morning.
Yes.
They are still fast. You cannot exhaust them.
Amen.
You can still count on God. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
You can turn to God today, somebody. Learn to God. Do not stay the way you are staying.
Yes.
Turn to Jesus.
Amen.
Shout like Batmaya. Jesus,
yes.
Son of God,
Amen.
Have mercy on me.
Amen.
You can shout today. In whatever situation or circumstance, you can shout to God today. Have mercy on me, oh God.
Amen.
Have mercy on me.
Yes.
If you have received Jesus Christ as your Lord, he is the expression of God's mercy. He bears the fullness of God's mercy.
Amen.
Turn to Jesus.
Yes.
Turn to God through him.
Yes.
He is the high priest.
Yes.
Whatever you have done, he is the advocate.
Yes.
Talk to him and God will forgive you.
Amen.
Not for your sake, but for Christ's sake.
Amen.
For the blood of Jesus is speaking better things.
Amen.
And if you are not born again, you can receive God's mercy.
Amen.
Forsake not his hand of mercy that he is extending to you today, saying, come, my son. Come, my son. Many have gone to hell for refusing God's mercy. God has given mercy. He doesn't want anyone to perish. God has given mercy. He does not want you to live oppressed by demons. He does not want you to see you oppressed. Yes. You are made in the image of God.
Amen.
And God does not like to see you. He values human beings.
Yes.
That's why he said in Genesis, that in Genesis 9, he says that whoever shall take away a man's life, let his life also be taken away. Amen. Because life, he has taken the life of that man. And the life is in the blood. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why Jesus shed his blood. He shed his own life. That was God's mercy.
Yes.
God's mercy for you. If you are there, you are saying you want to receive Jesus as you are coming to the cross. If you are there, you are saying, I want to receive Jesus Christ. You can pray after me. Say, Dear Lord Jesus.
Dear Lord Jesus.
I come to you.
I come to you.
I receive your mercy.
I receive your mercy.
Forgive my sins.
Forgive my sins.
All I have done since birth.
All I have done
to this point.
To this point.
I ask you, Lord.
I ask you, Lord.
Forgive me.
Forgive me.
And today.
And today.
Come.
Come.
And be my Lord.
And be my Lord.
And my Savior.
And my Savior.
Save my life.
Save my
life. Write my book.
Write
in your book.
In your book.
Write my name in your book.
Write my name in your book.
Save my life.
Save my
in Jesus' name.
In Jesus'
if you
name.
Have prayed that prayer, you are born again. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you have prayed that prayer, you are born again.
Amen.
Therefore, as we go to pray now, as you pray, I want to pray for you. If you have prayed that prayer, go to a Bible teaching church after the coronavirus. Find a pastor and he'll take care of and lead you to the right things. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray now. Father, I thank you for speaking to your people. And I thank you, Lord, that I have received your word.
Yes.
Father, I pray that your mercy be upon your people.
Yes.
As they turn to you to confess their sin or to forgive, mm-hmm. as they turn to you to ask for your mercy,
yes.
I thank you because your mercies are present mm-hmm. and they are everlasting.
Yes.
And I thank you because they are dear forever.
Yes.
Have mercy upon the people all
yes.
over the world.
Yes.
Have mercy upon the viewers, O God.
Yes.
And visit them at the point of their need.
Yes.
Visit them, Lord, no matter what. Even sickness, I declare they are healed.
Yes.
Let your power of healing be upon them.
Yes.
Let them be healed today in Jesus' name.
Yes.
I rebuke every sickness. I rebuke that sickness and pain. In the name of Jesus,
yes.
that is on your ankle, you who is watching.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus,
yes.
I rebuke every spirit of infirmity.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus, be healed.
Yes.
Be healed. Lord, heal their heartbrokenness.
Yes.
Heal their bodies. Heal their souls
yes.
in the name of Jesus. Let your people receive favor
yes.
because you are merciful God.
Yes.
Guide their lives and their steps.
Yes.
We thank you, Father, we honor you.
Yes.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
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 Amen. Shalom, shalom. God bless you so much for listening. God keep you. And sustain you because he is faithful. Blessed be the name of the Lord who is faithful. Amen.
Amen.
God keep you.